Good morning, students. Today in this tutorial, I am going to teach you the chapter The Secret of Being Loved by All. And by the end of this tutorial, you will be able to express story in your own words, meaning of difficult words and phrases, and answers of the related questions. Now, I'll tell you the summary of this chapter. A man named Satya Bhushan lived in Allahabad. He had a son named Ankit. He loved his son a lot and pinned all his hopes on him. He wanted him to be highly educated, but on the contrary, Ankit fell victim to the company of bad boys of his class. A day hardly passed when his father did not receive any complaint against him. Satya Bhushan tried hard to get Ankit back on track, but all his punishments failed. In fact, the more he tried, the more wicked his son grew. One day, Satya Bhushan called Ankit and gave him a wooden board and some nails. He said he got really sick of getting complaints against him every day and all his efforts to correct him had failed. So, he asked him to drive a nail into the wooden board whenever there was a complaint against him. But he must remember that he would not get any other board. Ankit gladly agreed, as he was not subjected to any punishment from his father. One day, there was no space left on the board to drive further nails into it. So, Ankit approached his father. His father gave him the solution that he can take out one nail from the board whenever he did something good to others. Ankit felt relieved and spent hours to think what good he could do to others. He constantly desired to do at least one good deed every day, and finally, all the nails on the board were taken out, leaving it clear. He rushed happily to his father to show him the clear board. His father also appreciated him and said that he would like to see how he could remove the scars left by nails, as it was a hard thing to do, but not impossible. Then, he had to do at least 2 to 3 good deeds every day. So, in this way, Satya Bhushan was able to bring his son Ankit on track. Now children, open your book Roots and Wings, page number 131, chapter number 10, The Secret of Being Loved by All. Now first we'll start with Get Set. Recall all that happened in the past 3 days in your everyday routine. Fill the lines with a smiley for each good deed that you did on each of the mentioned days. Count the total number of smileys you score. Children, this you have to do it by yourself. Now come to B part. How do you generally feel after you do a good deed? Discuss in the class. For this you can write down, it gives us immense satisfaction and pleasure. Now number 2, recount a good deed that made you feel very happy. Tell the class about it. Children, this you have to do it by yourself. You have to tell your own experience. But I'll give one example of it. For example, some days back, my friend Rohit told me how they were facing a serious financial crisis as his father, who had opened a new gym this year in January, wasn't able to earn anything. His father had invested a good amount of his fortune in it.
and because of lockdown, he couldn't operate his gym and they were left with hardly any money for food. I remembered I had saved around 8,000 in my piggy bank for buying a new bicycle. But a bicycle could obviously wait, so yesterday evening I bought some grocery for my friend's family. His father wasn't accepting it, but I told him that a son could help a father in need. He kissed my forehead and thanked me profusely. I had immense satisfaction and happiness in heart.
Now let's start with read and enjoy. Satyabhushan is a worried man as his only son Ankit has gone astray because of the influence of bad company. Here worried means anxious, astray means away from correct path, and influence means effect. Will he succeed in guiding his son to the right path? Will his son transform into a good human being? Let's read the following story and find out. Now here, guiding means show way to someone. Okay children, now we are going to start reading of the story. There lived a man called Satyabhushan in Allahabad. He had a son named Ankit. Satyabhushan loved his son so much that he had pinned all his hopes on him. Now underline all his hopes, and its meaning is dependent on someone for a successful result. He wanted him to be highly educated and join his roaring law practice after the completion of his education. Now here, the meaning of roaring is very successful. Now underline the phrase to be highly educated and write down zyada padha likha hone ko. And underline the phrase of his education and write down uski padhai ka. So here we have read that Ankit is the only son of an old man, Satyabhushan, and Satyabhushan, who is himself an advocate. See, we have read that his roaring law practice. So it means Satyabhushan himself is an advocate. So he wanted his son Ankit also to become an advocate like him and carry on the successful roaring law practice. Now let us move to the next page. But contrary to his cherished wish, his son fell victim to the company of bad boys of his class. Now, meaning of contrary is opposite to. Cherished means kept fondly in mind. And underline the phrase to his cherished wish and write down uski manchahi ichha ko. Hardly a day passed when Satyabhushan didn't receive one or the other complaint against his son from his school and the colony where they lived. So now we have read that Satyabhushan wanted his son to become an advocate, whereas opposite to it, his son who fell in bad company had gone astray, and Father Satyabhushan was receiving complaints from one or the other person against his son, Ankit. Now come to next paragraph. Satyabhushan tried hard to set Ankit right but failed miserably. Now miserably means unhappy or terribly. In fact, the more he tried, the more wicked his son grew. Wicked means evil or bad. Even corporal punishment at school failed to give him the desired result. Desired means strongly wished. And underline the phrase to give him the desired result and write down usko man chahe parinam dene ko. And Satyabhushan lost all hopes. Hopes means expectations
of his son's improvement. Underline the phrase of his son's improvement and write down the meaning. उसके पुत्र की बेहतरी के लिए. So even in the school, Ankit was punished by his teachers for not doing work or for being naughty. But still, those punishments also could not improve Ankit, and his father Satyabhushan had lost all hopes of his improvement. Now, where did Satyabhushan live? Satyabhushan lived in Allahabad. Whom did Satyabhushan love the most? Satyabhushan loved his son the most. Now, what is the name of Satyabhushan's son? Satyabhushan's son's name is Ankit. What did Satyabhushan want his son to become? Satyabhushan wanted his son to be highly educated and join his roaring law practice after completion of his education. What happened to Satyabhushan's son? Satyabhushan's son fell victim to the company of bad boys. Why was Satyabhushan upset? Satyabhushan was upset because he started receiving complaints against his son from his school and the colony where they lived. What happened to Ankit as days passed? Ankit grew up to be more wicked as days passed. Which kind of punishments were given to Ankit? Ankit used to get corporal punishments at school. Were the corporal punishments beneficial? No. The corporal punishments had no effect on Ankit. So children, this is all for today. Your homework is to read the chapter again and revise word meanings and phrases. Thank you.